whether you want to call it an extra-large Homo erectus or you want to call it Meganthropus, both those things are pointing towards a hominid that is decidedly more human-like than is the Gigantopithecus skull. Now, if you take a look at this reconstruction that Krantz did, I would give it a pretty good grade, because I think that since the original fossil occipital bone is completely present, the whole back side of the skull is the original fossil, I think this reconstruction is going to be pretty darn accurate in terms of the size of the cranial area here. So, you know, we can be pretty sure that that's a good job of reconstruction. On the Giganto, there's much more guessing involved because we don't have any of the skull bone from the top part of the skull. All we have is the jaw. But in this case, we have actual occipital bone, so we can say that this has a better chance of being accurate than this one does. Also, on the mandibles, even though we don't have the entire mandible as we do in the Giganto, we do have teeth from either side of the mandible, including parts that are on the curve. And so I think that with that being the case, we can also suggest that this is a pretty accurate rendition too, right here. Now, I've always thought that his jaw was well defined, but there would be others that would probably make some difference in the rami up here, and someone might suggest it could be a little smaller or what have you, but it's probably pretty accurate too. But this animal right here, even though it has a cranial capacity that's very close to the human skull here, you know, and obviously much bigger than even this larger Gigantopithecus, what's different is the jaw is really quite large compared to the human jaw by comparison. I would say you could easily say it's twice as big. And what you notice here is that this animal, this Meganthropus, and I like the word because it means giant person, giant human, giant man, it has this big bony ridge around the eyes. It's called the torus. It's got the sagittal crest right here, and it has a face. If you put the jaw and everything together, the whole face is really, really a lot bigger than the human's face by comparison, just in terms of the face. And when you look at a hominid, you look at the face primarily. But if you were to say comparing this face with this face, you would have to say that this particular creature, based on human standards, is a bit of a pinhead. In other words, it's somewhat microcephalic compared to the face size. It's got a tiny brain compared to its face relative to the human. And I would suggest that that's what's exhibited in the Patterson-Gimlin film. We see a large bony ridge around the eyes, so that the eyes are fairly deep sunk, just like we see here. We see a little bit of prognathism, and in some frames of the Patterson film, Patty almost looks ape-like, and this is exhibiting a bit of prognathism, much more than the average human would have. It has a sagittal crest. A lot of people suggest that this creature, the Patterson Bigfoot, has a sagittal crest. So, bingo! I personally think that the Meganthropus skull is a much better match with the Sasquatch shown in the Patterson-Gimlin film. And what's especially interesting about that from the point of view of our research here in Santa Cruz is that the tooth that one of our members found in Scotts Valley, just 4 miles from here, is also at least twice as big as the human tooth compared to it. The dentists I've shown this to say, based on the shape of the roots that are left and the shape of the tooth itself, it looks like a human upper molar, but it's way too big. And if we compare this to the teeth in here, oh, and let me point out one other thing. The crown is completely worn off the top of this tooth. Now, the way that would have happened is that the enamel was actually knocked off of there, worn down, apparently, because this thing was eating stuff that was so gritty that it wore the enamel right off the cap of the tooth. So if we compare this over here and realize this is actually less than the whole tooth. This has been broken, And two of the pieces were glued that we found, but we don't have the third piece. So you have to kind of imagine how big it would be with that extra part of that curve. And I would suggest that this is matching very nicely with this jaw. And these teeth are also very flat on the top as compared to, look at the Giganto teeth, they are not flat on the top. They have the various markings that you expect to see on the crown of a tooth, as do the teeth on this human jaw. So, all that being said, I personally think that this Meganthropus skull is a better match with the Patterson-Gimlin than is this Gigantopithecus skull. This is a better match with the human skull. And our tooth seems to match this jaw. So, I'm kind of happy with the way that all goes together. But, you know, that's just a hypothesis, and it just happens to fit nicely with our research here at this point.